Come out of the box.
Hello, YouTube. Cheers and welcome to The Basement. My name is Bruce Lively.
And I'm D-Boy Slim.
And The Basement is the first daily hip-hop debate show. From Tuesday through Friday, we tackle the most intriguing topics in hip-hop culture and the world around it. So welcome back, Basement family. So, once again, Eminem takes control of yet another award show. And at the iHeart Music Awards, this guy takes on the NRA head first. That NRA, National Rifle Association. And once again, he's not only current, but powerful in his statement. Listen, man.
Powerful enough, though.
Do we have to ask this question? Yes. This is a lesser asked question. I'm just going to come out with it. When it comes to the NRA, does it even matter? Who wins after a show like that? Today's question, Eminem versus the NRA. Who wins? With that being said, let go.
Listen, as I've gotten older in my, give the kids my age, but my 30 some odd years on this planet, the one thing I've learned, there is no winning against the NRA.
Oh man.
We've got,
wait a minute,
we got three branches of government.
Right, judicial, legislature, right, and executive.
Well,
they're not part of any of them. They're just a
let's just be honest. They're their own entity, and it's almost like they're an extended branch of the government. You know, any policies and laws that gets made and passed about anything dealing with guns or firearms, and you can better believe that the NRA is at the bottom of it. They funded it. You know, let's be honest, it's in their best interest to keep those laws flowing for the consumer that wants to buy guns, because they're the gun manufacturers and they stand, you know, to continue doing their business, making money off the firearms. So, you know, in this last election, there was a lot of talk about the NRA and gun laws being passed, or some people being too lenient on gun laws, in which this idiot has got in the office, and I don't know if he called himself being more vigilant or active as far as, you know, being on top of gun laws and policies, but
he has no idea about either any of those things.
As we can see,
whatever they tell him to do, he says okay.
It hasn't worked. You know, long story short, whatever it was, or whatever, you know, if he's even addressed it yet,
Obama couldn't do anything about it either. Nobody can.
It's gotten out of control. You know, we're at a point where our kids are practicing for intruders to come into school. Kids are coming to school shooting other kids, shooting teachers and faculty. I can't remember a time where gun violence has been so much out of control, unless we were at war or something. But just on our home turf and in our country, without, you know, any military involvement, the regular citizens of America, like, the gun violence every day is like, it's something. Then it's extreme. It's extreme. You see the kid go to the church or something and shoot up the church, or like I said, kids coming to the guy coming to school shooting up the school with innocent kids. Like, it's
yeah, I think it's the type of gun violence.
Right. It's become extreme.
Go ahead.
So let me just first say that I understand what Em is saying as far as challenging the whole idea or what the NRA has been about, or whatever the case. And Bruce will elaborate on that because they've had certain policies and laws passed. They help fund certain policies and laws to be passed. And like I said, it's
they more so fund the policies not to be passed. They were integral in getting rid of the
To have harsher
right AR-15s. They guns. Got that back on, okay. But most of the time when people try to make a restriction,
okay,
the NRA is paying them saying, "No, we're not going to pass that, are you?"
Got you.
Second Amendment.
Got you.
Yeah.
And so and let's be, you know, let's just cut to the chase. It as I said at the top of the show, it stands in their best interest. This is not about Democrat, Republican. This is not about saving a kid's life or not. This is they're keeping their business flowing. Period. And that's their bottom line. Let's just call it what it is.
They're run by gun manufacturers.
So
the more guns that they sell, the more guns they can make and
more money.
The more way to sell guns is to keep people scared all the time that there could be a shooter coming up in your school.
Meanwhile, every day you turn on your TV, a gun is in the wrong hands. It's in the hands of an idiot, a psycho, somebody disturbed, and he shot up a crowd or a large amount of people. But with that being said, to stick to the question of and the topic of the day, which was, does Eminem or the NRA win? Of course the NRA wins. I mean, as large a voice and platform that Eminem has right now, and we appreciated his rap that he did at the awards when he spoke about Trump. Everybody appreciated that. That was very timely. It was very on point. It was very necessary. Again, going up against the NRA is damn near like going challenging the government. They're arm in arm. They're on the same team. Like this, you know.
Listen,
you don't have no wins with that. There's no wins with that.
Man, I hear you, but the truth is, let's take a look at a stat that you said.
And Bruce, if you have any ideas as to how we go through that or around that, or
well, that's exactly what I'm getting.
Okay,
perfect. That's exactly what I'm getting to. Why I say, yeah, he wins. Let's look at the first stat. You haven't seen as much gun violence ever as you have now. Well, that's one, because technology allows us to see more. News is 24 hours a day when it wasn't 15 years ago. There was no CNN. There was no Fox News. There was your local news station. We never saw it that much. Leave It to Beaver was not how life really was. The actual stats say since 1960 till now, violent crime has gone down. You would not believe that if you listen to the NRA, because they want you so scared of someone always gonna rob you and you're king of the castle laws and you need our guns because the government's gonna come after us. Nigga, they got tanks and airplanes. The government comes after you, your AR-15 is worthless.
While we ranting and raving about gas, nigga, they made them gas. They got some shit that'll blow out our back from where they stay at.
But anyway, I say that stat to say nothing changed overnight. It was a long period of different laws. Then finally, when they passed the law that stopped automatic guns and semi-automatics from being sold, the crime went way down again. Unfortunately, NRA has bought their way back in. But you know how Eminem wins is because he helps to fuel the winners. The only way that you can fight or beat somebody that's paying people to make laws for you and your company, the only way in America is civil disobedience. That's the only way. You said it right. There's no way that you're going to get any of your congressmen, or you're going to elect somebody who's not paid off, because they all are, except Bernie Sanders. And even he, as a Vermont candidate, was pro-guns because people in his state love guns.
Yeah.
So, not anymore, though. But
which was a big criticism of his during the election, which was nonsense.
But let's get to how we change it. The kids know, just like the kids in the 60s knew, just like the kids in the 50s knew, just like the kids in the 80s knew. It's always with the kids because they're always the ones that's willing to march, that's willing to go out there, that's willing to fight back with vocal responses.
The front line.
The front line. And so what Eminem does, he's made, He himself doesn't win. What he did was he chose the winning side. This is what he did. And NRA, they have all the money in the world, but what we've seen is Florida now, because the winning side is out marching, because people can't deny the kids and the marches, they just passed a law raising the age from 18 to 21 to buy an assault rifle. That's a win. That's a win, because the 18-year-old can't get it now. Mm. The NRA sued them. I doubt that they win that lawsuit. NRA will continue to fight back, and if you think they're not going to fight back and you should just throw your hands up, then you give up. But what Eminem does is he raises the social consciousness of this issue, of any issue he talks about, because his people are those NRA members, those white folks that come from poor backgrounds, that most of them believe that the government's coming for their guns for some reason. But when he says it, he's talking to those same kids that's out there marching and got the law changed in Florida. And they're continuing to march. So every time he comes up and he's on the winning side, he wins. He wins, because the only way to change it is grassroots. The only way to change it is protest, is signs, and sometimes in the streets if you have to. But you're not going to change it by waiting on the NRA to stop paying off politicians, and you're not going to change it by voting in new politicians that don't take NRA money, because they don't exist yet. But they will. Just like how 1960s till now, the crime rate has gone down because certain things were passed. It takes time, but he's on the winning side. He wins.
One, I would like to challenge that statistic that gun violence has gone down since the
60s. All violent crimes.
I don't know about any other type of crime, but gun violence, there's more guns being made in this country than it ever was.
This is what I was going to say when you said that is the types of gun violence. All gun crime, violent crime, period, went down. They put a law on AR-15s and weapons that do mass damage.
And what? Not nationwide.
No, they did. They did. And that law got overturned at the end of the Clinton era. So there was a law. There was a time where there was a law that you can't own
automatic
weapons. Anybody who owns one is a criminal. And they kept them off the streets like that. And the only people who did it was the niggas that's killing themselves in drug wars. Mm-hmm. Not that we don't care about their life, but it didn't happen at a school or at a church.
In the 70s, the cop a Uzi.
It couldn't. Okay. You got to know somebody, and it's highly illegal. So now, it's probably still highly illegal to cop a Uzi, but AR-15 is not. Really?
No, it's not. Wow. It hasn't been that way in a while.
Wow. So when they got rid of that law, what we're seeing now is not that there's more gun violence, there's more mass shootings, because they're allowed to have the weapons that kill more people at one time. The one idiot that goes into a theater,
right,
into a theater and shoots 20 people, account for the 20 times that one person had to shoot somebody in the year. You understand what I'm saying? So it looks like it's more gun violence. It's not. It's just more mass shootings.
Well, I didn't want to get off topic, but here's my thing, and here's my closing argument. The NRA still wins, and we know that. You may win a battle, but we know the war is... If the war ended today, obviously, you know, the NRA would have won.
Luckily, it's not ending today.
There's not enough laws, or there's not enough policies to keep the guns, and those fully automatic weapons, out of you know, the crazed people's hands. If there was, then the shooting at the hotel or something in Florida wouldn't have happened.
Yeah, no, the hotel joint, you're talking about Las Vegas.
Was that Vegas?
Vegas, when he shot down from
a crowd
full of country music.
I mean, it's crazy. Jesus. It's crazy. So, with the AK.
Like a bunch of them.
Yeah, unfortunately, I still have to side with the NRA. If it ended today, you know, the NRA is winning. I mean, like I said, maybe a small victory or whatever side with M, or the side that M chose to stand with or whatever.
But
honestly speaking, and you know.
Luckily, it doesn't end today. When you ask Martin Luther King, did he win? At the time, they still had segregated bathrooms. problems in the black community.
And he would tell you, he would tell you today if he was still alive, we won a few battles.
But we won a few battles.
There's always a battle.
Yet to be won. Right, but in that case, I can say that there's always more battles to be won. You're never just out of it. People who think that they live in a utopia still have a problem with their government in one way or the other. We're winning. You have to win each battle at a time in order to win the war. And you only can win this battle with the change of social consciousness. And he's going to be on the winning side. When we look back, you'll say, he won that. He brought more people outside of their school. What happened yesterday? He got more kids to decide to go march than would have the day before he did that rap. And that was going to be the catalyst. Those are going to be the types of things that push progress. And that's the wrap up. That's the wrap up.
You keep a regular kid from going in the store buying an AK-47 or Tech 9 or Mac 11 or Mac 10 or whatever, then you're saying something. But
well, now, so look at the law. It went from 18 to 21. That same kid who got that weapon could not get it now, because the law has changed. That's a win.
And I respect the victories and the wins as they come, you know. But I would have to say the NRA will win. But what do y'all think?
What do you guys think, man? Leave the comments down there. This is kind of a serious topic, but it's one that needs to be talked about. We spoke about, I mean, the whole gun issue is pervasive in America. So it's like, we spoke about Jewel's running out the airport with his gun. We decided to come back again today with another issue on guns. What do you guys think? Leave them comments down there. You know what it is.
That's crazy. And for all you Memphis underground heads, we're going to be covering the Finesse 2-time situation too. Like, you know.
You already know. Speaking of that, let's get to these shout outs. Kadhafi Nunez, new subscriber. Salute. He said, I'm Brooklyn all day, but Lil Dicky is fire. Okay. Appreciate that. Appreciate that 100%. Kadhafi Nunez, thank you. Draco says, hate to kill y'all show, but Finesse 2-time's way hotter than Moneybag Yo.
There we go. See?
We coming that's back why, to Finesse 2-time.
That's
two
why
time.
We just said something about that.
Check it out, Draco. Matter of fact, tomorrow?
Yeah, we get on Finesse.
We'll get on Finesse tomorrow. We got some stuff to talk. We got another little argument to
appreciate
have about
the
that.
Comments, Draco.
All right. It's a drink. Says victory lap was extremely boring rapping and boring subject matter.
You see,
man, I don't even know. That's
is a drink. Listen, I know you know, everybody's used to the up tempo type flow, and that's what I found refreshing about he slowed the tempo back down. It reminded me of something from the 90s. It wasn't boring. It was very enlightening, informative, and educational, actually. But
and that might just be boring to you.
I didn't know who Dr. Selby was. It made me find out who Dr. Selby was.
Sometimes people don't want to think in their rap, and they had that opinion.
And we appreciate the comment, though.
They just want to dance. They like what they hear. It's a drink. Thank you for that comment, man. I don't know about boring, but I believe that Vince Staples wins that debate either way. And EA Productions says, Tienen que poner subtitles en español, meaning we need to put Spanish subtitles. I got that from what he said. So we're going to start doing that.
Look at my man going bilingual.
You know what I mean? We got to start doing that, and we're going to try our best. It takes a lot of time with the way YouTube has it going now, but I already fixed that show for you, EA Productions, and I hope I can get more in Spanish subtitles for you. Glad to have Spanish fans watching.
How about that? We got y'all.
That being said, go check out our Patreon page and buy them beats. It's the basement.
We out of here.
Peace.